Adults from Reddit, what do you regret most from your teenage years? I regret not caring about my education and future and caring more about doing drugs. Nothing. I always was and always will be a perfect individual. Edit. Now that I think of it, I regret lying to myself all the time. Thank God I stopped doing that. Being too hard on my parents. No one's perfect and they gave so much for me but my little itself never thanked them. Not asking out the girl who gave me tons of hints. Being not as interested in school as I could or should have been. I did okay but I could have done better if I wasn't as lazy or if I cared more. Not pushing harder to be myself and letting my fear of others' expectations define me. Edit. Thank you for the kind words. This was a wonderful thing to wake up to. Not learning to socialize better and build good study physical health habits. They're all extremely tricky habits to form as an adult. All these top comments sound like you all are nice people who just would have liked to have a bit more fun and self-expressiveness. I feel more out of place now that I look at my biggest regret. Man, my regret is just being so mean. It was not all the time though. It was just targeted to some people and only when I was feeling overwhelmed with social things. Instead of telling them that I wanted some alone time or something like that is adult sounding. I just yelled hurtful insults at them to make them go away. I know I made one girl cry. I felt bad immediately which just fueled my confused social emotions and made it harder for me to reconcile things with her later. I feel like I left a wake of destruction in my past. I had a mullet until 10th grade. I spent so much time waiting for something to happen. Like sitting on some steps outside of a house waiting for something to happen. Hanging out with people I did not really like waiting for something to happen. I feel like so much time was wasted waiting for something to happen. Instead of doing something or making things happen. Being afraid of girls. I wasn't super socially awkward or anything. I just had a pretty normal fear of rejection. When I finally realized that girls aren't some strange exotic species. That they were mostly just like me so wanting to hang out, make out, and likely duck so well I started to get a lot of action. And when I think back to some of the girls I knew were into me, but I was too afraid to act, damn. I was so, very, good, I was studious, I didn't party, I didn't drink, I didn't date, etc. I was my parents' dream child, and if I could go back I would have been at least a little bit bad. I missed out. Chasing girls that didn't want me instead of the girls that were very into me. Being so self-conscious. It stopped me from doing a lot. I'm so much more confident now and it feels great. I regret caring as much as I did. Always caring about how others viewed me. My friends. Teachers. Family. Etc. I spent so much time worrying about how people perceived things that I said or did. Whether they might take offense if I say I didn't want to do something etc. That I forgot to ever really consider how I felt in all of it. I regret quitting soccer because I knew my dad didn't give a rip about it. I loved that sport so much. I didn't make very many friends in high school. I had, like, my one best friend. And a few other girls I was on friendly enough terms with to eat lunch but never saw after school. But that was it. Years later, I went to my reunion and realized they were all lovely people who I'd be friends with today if we still lived near each other. I now live out of the country. And the issue at the time was with me, not with them. Shy isn't the right word for what I was then. I talked quite a lot but withdrawn definitely is applicable. It never occurred to me, for example, to actually invite someone to go do something. Never told anyone at school who I wanted to know better. Hey, want to hang out at the mall and go catch a movie, for example. Now of course I know that was silly, and it's not a huge shocker that I never got invites if I never extended them myself. But that just wasn't my thought process at the time. I grew since then, and I'm nowhere as withdrawn as I was, and I have enough friends to make me happy. But I am jealous when I see my brother and sister with all their friends from high school who they're still in touch with. Because one important detail about friendship you don't realize as a teenager is how wonderful older friends are who remember you and your life from different periods. My brother and sister have this in spades. And I just don't. When I was 16, a really beautiful 17-year-old from the grade above me who was way out of my league brought me into her room, closed the door, told me to sit on the bed, and began getting really deeply into conversation with me. Then she talked about sex for a while, touched me occasionally, and laughed at my dumb jokes. I left her house early. It wasn't until I was in my 20s that I realized what I had done. I'm 26 now and I think about it pretty much every few days because it took another 4 years for anything sexual to happen to me. Saw her recently and she's still beautiful. TLDR. Girl was into me and I was all MR. Magoo about it. Not being physically active enough. Not getting help for my depression sooner. My grades really suffered that year. Keeping the high school girlfriend through freshman year of college. The long distance thing was hard and unsatisfying. She would come up and be kind of a wet blanket and not be into partying. Or couldn't relate to the new friends I was making in college. Or I'd be taking the bus home every other weekend to hang out with her. Which meant more time around parents as she obviously still lived with hers. And I'd have to stay with mine. I did care for her a lot and we would have some fun. But I think I missed out on a good chunk of freshman life having to devote time to maintaining our relationship from across the state. So looking back, I think I should have ended it before I went to college. Not studying at all. I'm not thick but I was very lazy. With better results I now realize I could have gotten further faster. I ended up in several dead-end jobs before deciding I needed to actually try to make more of my life and going back to college. Not saving money. Work your ass off and save money while you live with your parents. Trust me. Don't waste it. It's not fun living pay to pay with bills out the ducking ass. Edit. To everyone saying that this wouldn't help at all. Read below. Say you put away $50 to $100 every 2 weeks to a month for 3 years. That's anywhere from $1,800 to $7,200 you have in your account building interest. You now have money put away for things such as if your car breaks down, lawyer fees, putting a down payment on a new car, in between jobs and have to pay important bills, rent, etc. It's just a good idea. Not knowing that the answers to most of my so-called problems or the ability to learn new skills could be found in books, like the books my dad gave me and I refuse to read, though. Not understanding my own power and worth. I was beautiful, strong, smart, athletic, driven and absolutely convinced that I was nothing. Self-conscious to the point of paralysis and certain that no one could possibly be interested in me or what I had to say. I look back now and can't believe I ever felt that way. As a 17-year-old, I'm thinking that I should probably start doing summit after reading this. Having crippling self-doubt and general social ineptitude. That and cancer. Going to a worthless ass Bible college and church 4 days a week because something was missing in my life so I made up Jesus. While normal people had six. Drank and went to parties. I went to church and hated myself for having six drinking and going to parties. The six I could have had. All those girls making eyes, the giggles, the sideways looks that you're not sure, man. Probably 2/3 RDS of those girls wanted the D so badly. About 2/3 RDS of those have later confirmed it, one way or another. I wound up breaking out my yearbook yesterday for the first time in a long time. I'm in my early 30s, and one big thing jumped out at me. For the most part, we were all beautiful. Seriously, it's incredible that so many people, myself included, spent high school feeling ugly and awkward and lacking all confidence. In reality, we were all young and fresh-faced and gorgeous. We ought to have woken up every morning, looked in the mirror, and thought, damn, I look amazing. But I'm sure many of us thought the complete opposite. Sadly, I think this is one of those youth is wasted on the young type of things. If 30-year-old me had traveled back in time and said this to teenage me, it probably wouldn't have changed my outlook that much. I had to live 15 more years, slowly decaying all the while, to see how fabulous I was back then. Not giving a duck in school. Do your homework, kids. You won't believe how much it will help you later. It's not necessarily the learning part of it. It's understanding how to push through the it that sucks so that you can enjoy the it that doesn't suck more. I don't exactly have any regrets, but I do miss the complete and total lack of social barriers, and having the stamina to literally bang someone from sunrise to sunset. Not respecting my body or my health, I regularly stayed out late smoking up with my friends and eating fast food at 2 a.m. I drank hard liquor most weekends in grade 12. I didn't have a healthy sleep schedule. I didn't care about properly hydrating my body with water. I didn't care about the lack of nutrition in the foods I was eating. I never exercised at all. Then, at 19, I moved to a new area away from those friends and that environment. And to fill my free time, I tried some new hobbies. I started waking up earlier and spending time outside. I started to enjoy nature and exercise. I didn't realize how much better my body and mind could feel by treating it to positive, constructive things. I had a fine teenage experience, but I wished I'd taken better care of myself. I'm almost 24 now, with entirely different values, and the healthiest I have ever been, mentally and physically. Rough breakdown of this thread. So 25% people who wish they had taken life more seriously, spend less time partying and having fun and more time studying and preparing for the future. So 25% people who wish they had taken life less seriously, spend less time studying and preparing, and more time partying and having fun. So 50% people who wish they had gotten laid more. Not realizing what a great time it was. Teenage years fly by and you barely even notice it. Now as an adult, I wish I could just slow the time down a little bit. I spent all of my teenage years in hospital because of an eating disorder, and my 20s now in my 30s and slowly getting my life together. I know that it wasn't exactly a choice, and the best thing I can do for myself is have compassion for my younger self. But it's really hard to not regret putting more effort into recovery and trying to heal my brain, rather than all the energy and effort I put into trying to destroy myself. Hindsight is 20/20, I guess. I feel like I missed everything. My parents were ultra conservative and I was brainwashed into thinking most music was evil. Certain games, D&D, Pokemon, were evil. Wasn't allowed to read Harry Potter. I have a hard time relating to my peers because my first experience with a lot of things that they enjoyed as a teenager came much later or hasn't happened at all, and it makes conversations awkward. I'm trying to catch up now on all the pop culture and video games, but it just isn't the same. Seeing Smashing Pumpkins on MTV at the time versus now is different. Playing Pokemon now when the systems aren't fully what they were, no Nintendo WFC, isn't quite the same. And I have no friends to play card games with. Edit. Wording. TL. Doctor, don't miss out on what's happening. Going back to it is not the same, and I regret not having fun with friends despite what my parents thought. Probably won't be seen. But my biggest regret was growing up too fast. I got a full-time job at 15. I worked two jobs at 16. And I was a manager at 17. I regret it all. I wish I had that time to be a teenager. Because once you start working, you can't stop. Not getting the good grades that I could have gotten. Spending all of my time worrying about how fat I was. I was 54 kilograms, 1.65 meters. I was thin. Today I am 87 kilograms and counting. I was going through off my old clothes yesterday and just realized how thin I actually was. I regret not doing things because I was stressed out about being fat. I wish I had enjoyed being thin while it lasted. I regret that I wasted so much time concerning myself with the business of others. My dad always encouraged us to mind our own business, which, he said, when done well, was a full-time endeavor. I regret worrying about trying to please an imaginary supreme being in the sky. Being super religious caused me to miss out on so many things. I was always too afraid of going to hell. I wish I had been free to experiment and meet people, more girls, and have guilt-free sex. My blatant disregard of my own health and safety. I'm very lucky I didn't end up dead. And as an adult now who has lost a number of people in her life, it makes me feel so bad for having put all my loved ones at risk of losing me due to one of the many stupid decisions I made back then. Trying to be edgy. I'll see old pictures of myself and cringe. Not the blue hair though. That was solid. Is it weird to say that I wish I had studied more? I was still a great kid in class. Finished top 5 and went to university etc, but as a kid I definitely liked to party a bit too much. Going back, I sort of wish I had tried to push myself into studying just to see how good of a grade I really could have achieved. Not coming out much earlier. There was this girl I was best friends with. We both had feelings for one another but never acted on them. Every time either of us were to get a new boyfriend or girl, the other would flip and get insanely jealous. What I really regret is not acting on the feelings and not giving it a relationship a go. She meant the world to me, and the fear of losing her made me never act. Eventually, I did lose her in one of the most heartbreaking of circumstances for me. That was almost 12 years ago. But I can't help but wonder as to what if. Take it from me, guys. It's better to gamble on a what if than live the rest of your life wondering what if. No one will say this, so duck it. Not spending enough time with my family. I was a young, rebellious piece of it, and I cringe every time I think about how ducking dumb, petty, rude and naive I was to them and anyone else. I don't hold many regrets, but not spending enough time with my brother who passed away a few years ago still haunts me. He would always call and just want to shoot the it about whatever, or maybe if I came over he would just want to play a quick NHL 07 match or maybe a round of pool. He loved me and wanted to spend time with me, and I took that for granted. He was epileptic since a child and I just figured he'd always be there. In short, he is my biggest regret. I miss him daily, and to remind myself to be a better person, I named my son after him. I'm not perfect and never will be, but I am making more of an effort to spend time with the ones I love. I regret the things I didn't do. I won't go into detail as there are so many. Girls, parties, sports clubs. I was pretty shy growing up. Go out. Live your life. If you fall down, dust yourself off and try again. Don't always wait to be asked. A combination of thinking I was too good in many ways, with not thinking I was good enough in many others. Nothing in between. Somehow I was never just normal in my own eyes. This led to either looking down on others or feeling horribly insecure at all times. It really stifled my development, because regardless of which one fit, I could never ask for help or admit that I didn't know something. If I could go back, I'd be more open to other people and actually admit my own mistakes, errors to myself as well as others. I'd ask for help when I needed it, and I'd probably be happier for it. Not trying my best. It would have cultivated the discipline and mental fortitude that I'm trying to get as an adult now. Looking back, I was seriously lost, lazy, and disliked doing hard things. But, after a few significant life experiences and harsh lessons learned from mistakes, I'm slowly turning my life around by simply doing my best every day. Sure, I still get lazy and feel like I don't want to do anything, but those occurrences are less intrusive, and I do what has to be done. Not getting help with my depression earlier. If I had a do-over, I would. 1. Spend more time with my little brothers. 2. Break up with my high school GF much earlier. Driving under the influence. Yes, I survived. And no, I did not ever hurt anyone or anything. But it was reckless and stupid and could have ended terribly. I also regret drinking cheap Mexican vodka for my 18th birthday in Austin, Texas. Getting blackout drunk, disappearing from my friends, and ending up in a stranger's house being raped. Had I kept my wits about me, I would not have freaked out my family. I was missing for about 12 hours, and would not have become an abuse victim. Not taking enough photos of my friends, no matter how embarrassing we were. Taking pictures that weren't posed, just natural. Some of us aren't here anymore, and it's nice to look back. Not realizing how beautiful I was, along the same lines. Caring about the opinions of people who shouldn't have mattered to me. Not investing in Bitcoin right out of high school. Can your parents be a regret? My father was not a good father. His actions and reactions in my teen years absolutely broke me. I'm middle-aged now, and although I'm living a pretty good life, I know that I'm not normal, and most of that can be attributed to my upbringing. I wish I would have dropped out of high school as soon as I could and got my GED. It was such a frustrating and depressing waste of time for me, and looking back, there was no good reason for me to be there. I didn't take very many chances when I was younger. Had I put myself out there more, I probably would have had a lot more fun when I was a kid, young adult. I didn't really embrace the idea of just doing what I want and not worrying about how other people would react until I was well into my 20s. Sounds lame, but not applying myself. I was a smart kid, but I had a hard time with anxiety and depression while living in a poor household with a single mom. I did drugs and dropped out of high school. I bounced back in my early 20s, but I kinda missed the boat on getting a proper education. I was working full-time and had a life started. I worked hard to get myself a pretty cozy job in the field of electrical engineering, as a technician, not an engineer. But without an education, I doubt I'll ever get to where I want to be. Instead, I'm going to keep working hard, pay my mortgage, and take care of my family. We'll scrape by, but we'll survive. Plot twist, though. I met my wife because I dropped out of high school and joined a band. Our paths wouldn't have crossed had that not happened. She got me a crappy customer service job, which got me a better job, which led me to my current job, my house, my wife, my daughter, my career. They wouldn't be here. I got my act together for a girl. I love my wife. I don't think she'll ever realize how she broke me out of the cycle of poverty and loserdom. Sometimes I get really self-critical over being a complete duck-up as a teenager. But that actually set up the decent life that I now have. I mostly regret not getting my ass into college in my early 20s so I could be making fat engineer dollars instead of decent technician dollars. Being so mean to my parents. Being an asshole and not enjoying my family more when I lived at home. Told my buddy a smack on the ass isn't gay as long as you say good game. He proceeded by doing exactly what you described. Dart mind changed. I regret that I didn't spend more time having fun with friends instead of being so dedicated to getting ready for college and working as many hours as possible to help pay for it. There was no balance between work and play, study and free time. I'm 30 now. Start lifting weights. Don't wait till you are an adult. I see all the progress I made in just a year since I started and imagine what I could be like if I stuck with it when I started at 15. Don't be lazy. I am gifted in many things and am only now seeing my natural talents developed after a stint in the military and finishing college. I wish I would have been more motivated to develop as a person at a younger age. Women. That girl on the back of the bus who says she has something in her eye and asks if you can blow it out, kiss her after you do. Stop being a pussy. Separately, if you are attracted to someone but your friends are not, duck it. It's not that easy. For the love of God, don't get married as a teenager. Something I did do right. Be kind to everyone. It is appreciated by those who are alone, awkward, shy, etc. They will bloom when they are ready and will remember you for your empathy and compassion. Sometimes they become great friends and are wickedly attractive too. Good luck on all your future endeavors, my apprentices.